Hello everyone, today I'm here to discuss about International Financial Reporting Standards, its applicability and convergence with Indian Accounting Standards. I'm Professor Manjula Devi P, working as Assistant Professor in GFGC Kanakapura. This topic comes in BCom 5th semester, Bangalore University, and many other universities also have this as part of their syllabus. So let's see what is this applicability and convergence of IFRS into Indian AS. First and foremost, you should have an idea about what is IFRS. IFRS means the International Financial Reporting Standards. These are the set of rules which guides in the preparation of financial reports. This gives a framework for the companies who are operating at the international level. Now, when it comes to Indian accounting standard, these are the accounting standards which are prepared by Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, and they do give set of framework for the preparation of financial reports in the boundaries of Indian territory. Now, as we are in a globalized world, now the companies are working across the boundaries. So then which one to follow? Whether to follow IFRS, being an MNC, should I follow IFRS or should I follow Indian accounting standard? Like if you see the companies, like Infosys is there everywhere. If you see Biocon, it's there everywhere. I mean to say in many parts of the world. Again, same way, many foreign companies are also, like Samsung, have their own unit in India. Same way, Toyota has their own unit in India. Same way, there are many foreign companies are also operating in India. Now the question comes, when they're operating at the international level, what should they follow? Whether they follow that particular country's accounting standard or this internationally accepted accounting standard. And there are many technical issues, like every country has their own taxation policy, has their own corporate policies. So now, of course, this accounting standard is also part of the policy. So now the question comes, what to do, how the companies have to resolve this issue. Anyway, by the end of this discussion, you'll have a clear idea about what the companies do. Let's see what we have next. Yeah, here in my talk, I'll be using the terms Indian Accounting Standard. In the short form, I would say IND-AS, and I have IFRS, which is International Financial Reporting Standard, and I also use IASB, which means International Accounting Standards Board. So what is this meaning of convergence of IFRS with Indian Accounting Standard? In simple words, convergence would mean bridging the gap between the two, like we have IFRS and we have Indian Accounting Standard. Convergence means bridging the gap between two. That means making both in the way that Indian Accounting Standard go how International Financial Accounting Standards look like, that is IFRS look like. Then basically this convergence will involve alignment of two set of standards. So let's discuss about first and foremost IND-AS, that is Indian Accounting Standards. As I've already mentioned, it is actually formulated by Accounting Standard Board of ICAI, that is Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. So this standards are prepared or framed by keeping the economic environment of the country. Then again, they are made to suit the companies and disclosure requirement of Indian government. Like India has its own taxation policy, its own corporate policy. So what is the requirement according to that? These standards are formulated. On the other hand, if we see IFRS, these are made keeping the global standards and environment in mind. And we need a convergence, that means we need to build the gap between these two, that is converging the IFRS with Indian accounting standards. So here what basically they do, convergence will involve alignment of two sets of standards. The compromise is done by adopting the policies of the IFRS either fully or at least partially. So here, Indian accounting standards are formulated or like converted in such a way that it goes in line with the IFRS or it matches with the requirement of IFRS. Instead of directly adopting IFRS by the Indian companies or the companies who are operating inside the country, what they do, they'll convert the Indian accounting standards in such a way that it matches with the IFRS requirement, so that wherever they present their books of account, it would look similar, because though they are following Ind AS when they're operating in India, but it is same as IFRS. That means it is framed according to the IFRS requirements. So what are the benefits of this convergence of Ind AS with IFRS? So basically, beneficial to the whole economy. How does the economy gets benefited? See, if it is so user-friendly, if it is so conducive for the corporate environment, definitely it attracts foreign capital or it attracts foreign investment. More and more the foreign investment comes to India, it is beneficial, so that the country gets capital formation, so the production of goods and services, the employment gets generated, then the standard of living improves. So because of all that, IFRS, this convergence of Ind AS with IFRS benefits the economy. Again, to the investors, so when it comes to the foreign investors who are operating in India, it will give them the confidence that the accounting standards followed and practiced in the country is in line with the global world. So they would get the confidence, and it is easy for them to compare the performance in the country and also outside the country. So it helps the investors and also to the industry. So the big relief for the industry, because they don't have to make different sets of books of account for presenting to different countries. For example, a country is based in US and it has branches all over the world. So now when they are operating in India, if they are following Indian accounting standard, which if it is not converged with IFRS, then when they are presenting in US, they have to prepare according to the US standard. So then it will be like doubling of the work. Likewise, as they are operating in many parts of the world, they have to keep many sets of records to suit with the requirement. So, but if they have one standard or the standard which is in line with the IFRS, then they don't have to make much changes. They can present it and it is easy for them to compare the performance from one country to the other country. And again, more transparency, as the countries are following the same rules everywhere, then it helps in more transparency. Cost saving. Why it is cost saving? Of course, it saves a lot of energy and also the investment and on softwares and all, because you're following the same method, same software everywhere, which is in line with IFRS. And of course, the human resource is saved because they don't have to make multiple records or they don't have to duplicate the work according to the requirement of each country. So that way it also helps in cost saving. So in today's global world, every country almost are converging their accounting standards with IFRS. Okay, instead of directly adopting IFRS, they're making changes in their own country's accounting standards so that it suits the requirement of IFRS. So this is the list of Ind AS which are in convergence with IFRS. Means if you see what IFRS needs and if you see the Indian accounting standard, it is the same. Maybe the numbers are different. Like IFRS 1 may be something, Ind AS 1 may be something, but the contents, when they talk about, say, inventories, suppose Ind AS talks about inventories. So the way inventories are treated, recorded in Ind AS is exactly same as how it has been proposed in IFRS. So same way, whether it comes to Ind AS 7, which is about statement of cash flow, Ind AS 8, which talks about accounting policies, changes in accounting estimates and errors. So likewise, all the Indian accounting standards which are formulated are in convergence with the IFRS. So these are the list of Ind AS. And of course, in the coming sessions, we'll discuss some of the Ind AS in detail as you have in your syllabus. So in total, right now, we have 41 Ind AS, which is in convergence with the IFRS. So just to have a recap, so Indian accounting standards are framed, keeping in mind the economic environment and practices of India. But at the same time, IFRS is made, keeping in mind the standards of the global world. Now there has to be a bridge or there has to be, you know, a comparison between what Ind AS says and what IFRS says. So when they converge, both of it, that means bridging the gap between these two. So making Ind AS in the same way what IFRS would look for. So then it is called as convergence. So now if you see the global world, whichever the country, or especially if we talk about Indian country, so Indian accounting standards are in line with IFRS. So you can further refer the topic in these references, and hopefully you have understood the topic. We'll discuss many more Ind AS and also concepts about IFRS in the coming sessions. Thank you very much.